It's one of those situations with warm up. Like a lot of times you have people that come in, they just do like a slew of like a bunch of different exercises, and it ends up almost like feeding into their sets, where they're like fatigued before they even get to their work, but they're also doing things that like fatigue their body, not even getting them prepped for the actual exercise. So if we're doing barbell bent over rows, for us to come in and start doing like tricep extensions or lunges or like glute bridges or something like that, like it's not gonna really like assist us in the exercise. So instead of just like going through trying to get a sweat in, at that point just get on the treadmill and start walking or get in the sauna and start sweating. Like there's no point just trying to build up a sweat, get your heart rate up by doing a bunch of exercises that have no like implications on your actual like working sets. So Nick said it really, really well. If you're gonna come in, you have no like real issues with your, you know, back, scaps, you know, spine, then go ahead and just get on the barbell and start working. Work some like lower weight sets, make sure you're getting your bar path right, getting all that stuff right, but then just start like getting into your working sets. For both of us, I mean, T-spine's an issue, so we need to get into certain end ranges, make sure that we can stay strong in it. So we start with mobility in it to get to the end range, then we work in static to get the strength in those end ranges, and then we're obviously loading it. So that's kind of the main focus of the warm-up, is just getting in those positions and then starting to load it. We're doing these barbell bent over rows. Obviously, we can switch up either from a pronated grip overhand or a supinated grip underhand. For me personally, I can get into a better position when I'm supinated. Plus, like biomechanically, if we're in a supinated position, we can get into extension a little bit easier. Pronated is going to obviously be a little more focused on like posterior delt, mid back, mid thoracic. So if you're struggling on like getting into a better bar path on a barbell bent over row, I would suggest trying to get into a more supinated position. You can also change your arm angle if you do like a hex bar. You can get into a neutral grip. It'll be a little bit more lat focused and even bicep focused. But when we're in that position, we just want to make sure that our arm is staying in a position where we can get full extension on the lat. If not, then we're going to compromise on the shoulder. We're going to start rolling ourselves forward. It's gonna cause a lot of like impingements, pain on the front side of that shoulder. So Nick's more of a pronated grip guy when he's doing these. I like to go pronated when I'm doing dead stop, just because of the stability I can create in my upper back. But when I'm doing a barbell bent over row, I like to stay in that supinated position just as I feel like I can get a better stretch in my lat. My protraction feels a lot better in that position. And I honestly just feel it in my lat a lot more. So.
Hundred hoes at the hotel. I got a win, I can't fail. New foreign, not the Chevelle. Yeah. I got my drip out of mail. This drip ain't going on sale. Banging my gas to unpale. Can't fuck with you, petty LaBelle. Me and my brother like Ken and Kel. Send the rest of my niggas in jail. Now the smoke with that demon fish tail. Niggas hoes and they starting to reveal. Damn, I hope he don't tell. He solid, I'm paying his bills. In the fiction, we keeping it real. I keep me in hammer, no nails. Smooth out the condo, the L. Shoot it like run on the ops. Shoot out the Cody dissolving these pills. Gucci drip down to my socks. Gucci drip. Draw the hell cat out of hell. When it's time, Mika the Fox. Mika the Fox. New Richie, Millie, my watch. Millie, my watch. Yeah. If we slamming, I'm slamming you out. I let too many vibes in the house. I can't fuck, then I'm kicking you out. I'm still matching my bed with a pouch. I'm a young guy, some mix with a scout. I done stacked me a bigger amount. Had to show you what gonna be bout. Yeah. I do this shit with no vow. I let your bitch rip it round. Fucking that ass in the mouth. Glad that I came out the south. Made it through hate and the doubt. Dripping and gave me some clout.
It gave me some
took a G5 through the clouds.
Yeah,
100 hoes at the hotel. I got a win, I can't fail. New foreign, not the Chevelle.
Yeah,
I got my drip out of mail. This drip ain't going on sale. Banging my gas on pale.
Got big guns, night will. Don't make me one kill. Fuck the ride off pill. Whoa, yeah. All white gold, no steel. Rose gold, link on chill. My diamonds, they till. They hit white, indie lights. And at night, can't tell. You know that my name ain't ring bells. You know I'm hot like a light bill. I put my dick in your female. No pasta, but make a Michelle. The Lambo, I need a seatbelt. 200 my dash, you could tell. You racing, but chasing the tail.
So. Started off with Barbell Bent over rows, in that supinated grip for me, pronated grip for Nick, working a lot more of the movement. This it's like lat pull down machine is pretty like simplistic, so we can just really like push output is all we're really trying to do on here. Gets us in a good arm path, and we can just kind of load it and go.
Unibrow, so my Glock, your name help. Took me one whole day to fly that bitch and she Australian. What's her name? Don't look like a snitch, so I ain't with the telling. Yeah.
100 hoes at the hotel. I got a win, I can't fail. New foreign, not the Chevelle. I got my drip out of mail. This drip ain't going on sale. Banging my gas on pale.
Whoa, we just been living it better. What's up? We want the smoke, that's forever. Feel like the mice wanna race to the jet. Yeah, if it helps, we came straight out the shelter. Yeah, we came straight out the shelter. Whoa, yeah, I gotta burn it and melt you. You got a cost that they dealt you. They mad a nigga ain't felt them. Whoa, yeah, whoa, F'ing as light as a feather. Yeah, hit them 2 times, Raymond Felton. We still in a race for the cheddar. Whoa, yeah, whoa, gonna go in and attach the swerve. Doors up like a feather. Swear, pulling in every time that we let them. Yeah, whoa. Slimey, yeah, we slime. AB Hoopla for the time. So a hoe can't waste my time. No, baby VVs cost a dime. Streets ain't up, man, gonna got the iron. Whoa, yeah.
100 hoes at the hotel. I got a win, I can't fail. New foreign, not the Chevelle. I got my drip out of mail. This drip ain't going on sale. Banging my ghetto on pale.
Everyone starts somewhere, and they start with something. For me, like, the gym's always been like an oasis for me to like just get away from problems and all that stuff and be able to push myself in the gym. So for me, this is like a really, really good place to just like let my mind go, lose myself in my like craft, get better at what I want to do. Obviously, like growing in it, learning from it, like really indulging in the aspect of lifting and trying to get better at it from like a mental standpoint as well as a physical standpoint is important. But I love the gym. This is like a one place in the world where I feel like I can push myself and succeed and not have a lot of like issues affect me on the outside looking in.
Walking with my 40, and my money showing. Walking with like standing beer,
comfortable. Deal my cologne. Smoking gas is strong. Leave me alone. Stop calling my phone. I already know what you think, little baby. Don't know what I know. She said, Uzi, baby, they ain't got no dough. Why you're so dope? Yeah, you let you know. I'ma let you know. You can't keep them close. Time is dead, so froze. Why they like the boat? Spanish girl named Rosa. And she from the coast. But she know I'm a soldier. Girl, I let you know. I'ma let you know. Time is dead, so froze. Why they like the boat? Spanish girl named Rosa. And she from the coast. Yeah. Get that punch like I'm supposed to. Get that notch like I. Boy, you took a L and we can see that. Stevie Wonder, Ray Jordan, don't concede that. Pocket giant, just like Andre, dig the number through three stacks. I get money for you, bitch, stay real. Ooh, that's three facts. Diamonds on my fist, my wrist, my grill. Ooh, I mean that. Made a girl swallow my dick like a pill. Ooh, don't relapse.
She keeps stalking on my phone, think this thing's tapped. Diamonds all up on my pinky, think this thing's tapped. I do not fuck with these niggas, man, I mean that.
Whoa, money envelope, I was just a broke. I didn't know, now I let you know. I'ma let you know, you can keep it going. Diamonds dance so close, wanna let go more. Spanish girl named Rosa, now she found it close. She know I'm a soldier. I'ma let you know, diamonds they so froze. Body like a boat, Spanish girl in rose. And she from the coast, yeah. Body on your pulse, get that punch like I'm posted. Get that notch like I.
Here, big P's, you do 2RIR. Train more than that. No, I just had a note in my notepad on my phone that says don't leave reps in reserve on lateral raises and curls. It's like if you look at our kind of plan today, it was like skill, output, isolation. On isolation work, like you're not gonna overdo a bicep curl. You're not gonna overdo a rear delt fly, you're not gonna overdo a lateral raise. If you do, it's volume, it's not intensity. So like train that shit to failure. It's not very loadable. Like the most we even do on a dumbbell curl is what, like 45s?
45s, so like, or 50s, and even that too, like those exercises, because they're in isolation, like you're doing them towards the end of your workout, like half, almost all the movements we did today are going to involve the bicep in some type of position, mm-hmm. right? So it's going to be like pre-fatigued relatively. So like going into isolation, you're kind of just getting like the rest of that muscle worked out, mm-hmm. getting it to failure, and then like obviously you're going to recover from it, but it's not like a... Your CNS is not going to be fried because you failed out on your bicep curls no. throughout the week.
Yeah, I think people like to bastardize intensity as like a setback for recovery, when in reality it's probably volume.
Yeah.
Like volume is probably going to be more of a correlate to poor recovery than intensity.
Yeah.
It's like we're not having poor recovery because we did 2-3 sets to failure on bicep curls. It's because we did like 4 or 5 sets of 20. Like we did over 100 reps.
Yeah.
Not to failure.
Of Lou raises.
Of Lou raises.
I'm just trying to live my life. I'm just trying to do what's right. I'm just trying to get inside. I'm not trying to sleep all through the day and get up at night. I'm trying to do it right. Cause somebody show me the light. I'm just trying to live my life. I'm just trying to do what's right. I'm just trying to gain sight. I'm not trying to sleep all through the day and get up at night. That was lit. Yeah. Everybody know the real me. Something in your mind to feel free. So hot they don't wanna kill me. Been forever, but I'm still me. I'm
I'ma be real, I'm the man. I'ma be real, I'm the rapper. I'ma be real, I'm that motherfucker making me.
More horizontal pull focused. Barbell bent over rows. Hit lat pull down machine for more output. Chest supported rows, output. Posterior delt, output. Isolated bicep. Hit preacher curls. Incline dumbbell curls. And high KO bicep curls. So, sets and reps, like we talked about earlier in the video, we're working more output, so it's kind of more fatigue based on a lot of these exercises, going to relative failure, as long as the like movement's staying pretty executed correctly. But yeah, a little bicep day. We got an arm day tomorrow, just for some fun. And then we'll be back with some legs on Friday. So, peace.